We have 2.5 million photographs here, almost all of which deal with Indiana University history. One of my favorites in the archives, all-time favorites, probably in my top five, is this photograph of a young Herman Wells on a stuffed horse. This photograph was actually found in his desk drawer after his death. As far as we know, nobody at IU had ever seen this photograph before. I just wish we knew more about it. We know that it was shot by Rise Photo Studios. They were based in Rapid City, South Dakota. We're just guessing that this is about 1927. Herman Wells was working on a master's degree at Wisconsin at that time, so it puts him closer to South Dakota geographically. But it's a great photograph. I mean, there is no other photograph like this of Herman Wells doing something wild like this. What I like about Leon Varjian is that he was a real campus character. For several years, he held what most students at that time will remember as the Banana Olympics. They had different events in the Banana Olympics. One was banana balancing. One was rolling a banana across the finish line, throwing bananas. One was a banana in your ear contest where you had to lay down on the ground on your side and balance a banana in your ear. And the person that could do it the longest was the winner. And the awards were gold, silver, and bronze bananas. The next photograph is Hobie Billingsley, who was, in my opinion, the diving coach of all time. And of course, he coached here at IU with Doc Councilman, and they had an unbelievable string of, you know, national championships in swimming and diving. But what is not known about him by many people is that he was a clown diver, you know, where they do funny things on the diving board, and in this case he's somewhat dressed up as a clown, and you know, they just do funny dives or they fall. But he did that for at least 10 years. I think it was more like 12 years though. It's hard to believe that Disney Studios actually designed this for Indiana University. The cost was $1,400 at that time. This is at an October 15th, 1966 football game. A student by the name of Maury Erickson, he's the one in this costume. His big complaint at the time was you couldn't see. While I have not been able to find out, I think that's why there's actually, I think this is an IU cheerleader leading him, because the person couldn't see in there. But it's just a horrendous costume. Who has ever seen a two-legged bison? And there were a lot of complaints about it at the time. All you have to do is go into the Indiana Daily student newspaper or other newspapers, and people are asking, what is that thing walking around the football field? This is one of my favorite photographs. This is the filming of Breaking Away in Sanders Quarry. You can see the filming crew on a pontoon boat. Summer 78. Movie was released July 20th, 1979. A lot of people don't know the working title for the movie was Bambino. It was written by IU alum Steve Tesich, who wrote in the Little 500. And the Dave Stoller character in the movie is based on Dave Blaze. I did a little research. It's on the American Film Institute's 100 Most Inspiring Movies. It comes in at number 8. And Sports Illustrated listed it as number 8 of the best 50 sports movies of all time. This one's actually not a photograph. This is an actual drawing, the first rendering of the seal of Indiana University. It appears in the Board of Trustees minutes for July 21st, 1841. And they wanted a seal for the university. Of course, we'd been around since 1820. First classes weren't taught till 1824. First graduating class is 1830. But now by 1841, they're saying we should have a seal. And there is a mistake in the seal. They have the date of 1830 for the founding. So they have one too many X's in there. It should be 1820. We have several images like this of one of the Monon locomotives. This is when train travel was still the big thing. When you went to the Purdue game at West Lafayette, most of the people from Bloomington got onto one or two or three trains, special trains, that would then take you up to the game that day and bring you back that night. You can see that it's all decked out with Indiana Scrapping Hoosiers. You have the IU logo on the front. The conductor and his crew, they're actually wearing sweatshirts with Indiana on the front, and then they're wearing leather, of the time, leather football helmets. This is the November 22nd, 1930 train on its way to Purdue. We beat them that year, 7-6, by the way. It's an aerial 1930 or 1931 photograph of the IUPUI campus, showing the four main structures on campus at that time. We have at what at that time was the Ball Nurses Home. Today it's the Ball Residence Hall. And then the Coleman Hospital for Women, which is today just Coleman Hall. And then the Long Hospital, which is today known as Long Hall. And then in the background, along with the power plant, is the original Riley Children's Hospital. But again, I like this photograph because it just shows how things have changed, obviously mostly for the better. And you just look how barren most of the rest of the area is around these buildings back in 1930 and compared to what's there today. Okay, this is a image of a Quonset hut on campus that actually stood right out here in the parking lot of the Wells Library. This Quonset hut was actually used by Joseph Muller and his team as they developed the formula that became Crest toothpaste. The Crest tests were held in this building and in other buildings, of course, but many people that still live in Bloomington remember coming to this Quonset hut to get their new tubes of toothpaste and to have their teeth checked. This was all during the Crest tests. I did a little checking, and back in the 40s and 50s, cavities were one of the most prevalent health problems in the U.S. And when they came up with this formula, they cut that in half. And that was just huge at that time. Graham Martin. He graduated from IU with a history degree in 1941, came back to get a master's in education, finished that in 1954. He was on the football team here at IU. But what I never knew about him was that he is what they call one of the Golden 13. This group of 13 African Americans that went to the Great Lakes Naval Training School in 1944, and those 13 became the first African Americans commissioned into the U.S. Navy as officers. And there had been upwards of 100,000 African Americans that had been in the Navy, but none of them had ever been officers. So Graham Martin, a graduate of Indiana University, was one of those first 13. This may be one of my all-time favorite photographs in the archives. This is the IU football team after they beat Purdue in 1945. And this is our only undisputed Big Ten championship. We were 9-0-1. We did have another one in football in 1967, of course, but it was a three-way tie that year in the Big Ten. One of the reasons I love this photograph is not only just because they're so happy, but it's one of the most candid photographs we have from a time period when you're still taking formal portraits and formal group shots. We do have images of them practicing, which are also candid, but we don't have anything like this for this time period anyway.